Good evening. My name is Dr. Evozeni Deka. I'm working as a demonstrator at Guwahati Medical College and Hospital, Guwahati, Assam state in the country, India. So the case report is adult tetralogy of Fallot, a Doppler echocardiographic finding. Now, first coming to the introduction part. In tetralogy of Fallot, the morphological abnormalities are overriding of aorta, pulmonary obstruction, right ventricular hypertrophy and ventricular septal defect. There are two types of TOF depending upon the flow across the ventricular septal defect. Non-restrictive, where there is free flow across the ventricular septal defect, and restrictive, where there is a restriction of flow across the tricuspid valve. There are four types of TOF depending upon the anatomical structure: TOF with pulmonary atresia, TOF with absent pulmonary valves, TOF with double outlet right ventricle, and TOF with atrial ventricular septal defect. The incidence of TOF is 1 in 3500 live births, and incidence is equal in both and male and female. Cases are usually sporadic. There are about 3% risk of familial recurrence. Cytogenic abnormalities detected so far in TOF is trisomy 13, 18 and 21 and microdeletion of chromosome number 22. In case of trisomies 13, 18 and 21, this account for 10% of TOF cases, and gene responsible for it are still to identify. In chromosome number 22, there is microdeletion of TBX5 gene, which may account for 15% cases of TOF. Then there are another chromosomal abnormalities detected so far. These are 47XX, 47XY, 47XXX, 47XYY, and there is microduplication of chromosome number Y can be also possible. There are other abnormalities like deletion of chromosome number 5 and 6. There may be translocation in chromosome number 10 and 13, translocation between chromosome number 1 and 9. These trisomies and translocation may be found isolated or in combinations. In 4% of tetralogy of Fallot patients, there is mutation of NKX2.5 gene. In Allegheny syndrome, there is higher incidence of TOF, which involves mutation of JAG1 gene. A few patients in Holt Oram syndrome have mutation of TBX5 gene with tetralogy of Fallot and FOXC2 in hereditary lymphadenitis disease, in which CR patients also have tetralogy of Fallot. Now, the Steno of Denmark described tetralogy of Fallot in 1673, and Marsilis coined the term tetralogy of Fallot in 1808. Co-associated cardiac anomalies are right aortic arch absent or present, ductus arteriosus, persistent left superior vena cava, endocardial cushion defect, aberrant right subclavian artery, left pulmonary artery sling, major aortopulmonary collateral, tricuspid atresia. Among these, right aortic arch is most common, followed by presence or absence of ductus arteriosus. The non-cardiac abnormalities are hypoplasia of the nasal bone, short, long bones, growth restriction, then hypoplasia of the thymus, nuchal fold thickening more than 6 mm, single umbilical artery, ventriculomegaly, heterogeneous echo pattern of the liver, hypoplasia of the phalanx, echogenic bowel, echogenic kidney, club foot, omphalocele, low set ears, overlapping of the fingers, arachnoid cyst, microcnea, ectrodactyly, cystic hygroma, strawberry shaped skull, long eyebrows, cerebellar hypoplasia, hypoplasia of the lung, esophagotracheal fistula, exencephaly, hemivertebra. Majority of patients with TOF die due to severe right ventricular outflow tract obstruction. Severity of obstruction increases with advancement of age. Uncorrected, 25% patients die with cyanotic spells by first year of life, 40% by 3 years of life, 70% by 10 years of life, and 95% by 40 years of life. And 50% of the patients are diagnosed antenatally by fetal echocardiography requiring for postnatal prostaglandin therapy if there is evidence of severe right ventricular outflow obstruction. Other useful tools are chest radiograph, electrocardiogram, echocardiogram. In chest radiograph, the typical presentation of the heart is boot-shaped heart. The clinical manifestation or clinical view is upturned apex, concave male pulmonary artery segment. In ECG, We mainly found right axis deviation, prominent R waves, upright T wave in V1, S wave posteriorly and anteriorly. So abnormalities after 10 days of life up to 10 years of age and a QR pattern in the right precordial lids are also found. If the ratio between pulmonary artery orifice diameter to the aortic artery diameter is less than 0.3, primary repair is unsuccessful. In that case, we must go for the shunt surgeries, which are palliative procedures till permanent repair can be done. This should add proper assessment of coronary artery origin. Different shunt surgeries are pot shunt, black lock tossing shunt, water shunt. With advancement of age from less than 1 year to 5 years in patient with TOP, there is increase in incidence of myocardial fibrosis resulting in right ventricular myocardial dysfunction. In pathology of fallot, echocardiography show right sub-aortic perimembranous ventricular septal defect with 50% aortic override. Large ostium secundum atrial septal defect, second septal leaflet of the tricuspid valve with thickened septal leaflet of the tricuspid valve with severe tricuspid regurgitation, pulmonary valve thickening, dilated and hypertrophy right ventricle, not visualization of the coronary arteries. In my case report, this is a case of adult tetralogy of fallot coming to outpatient department of cardiology with complaints of chest discomfort and sometimes cyanotic spills. Age of the patient is 42 years male. Doppler echocardiography was done. In image, overriding of aorta was found around 20% over intraventricular septum. Left-sided aortic arch was detected along with ventricular septal defect with size 14 mm. Size of the pulmonary orifice is 10 mm and depth of the aortic orifice was 22 mm. Hence, pulmonary artery orifice was found to get stenosed. Now coming to the discussion part, Singh B. Mohan J.C. in 1992 found normal aortic orifice to be 15 to 23 mm in size and pulmonary orifice 15 to 22 mm in normal Doppler echocardiography. Here in this case, pulmonary orifice diameter is 10 mm, so stenosed. According to finding of Awasthi and S. Radhakrishnan in 2013, ventricular size can be determined from Doppler echocardiography. BSD size is mild if it is 1/3 of the aortic size, moderate if it is 1/3 to 2/3 of the aortic arch, and large if equal to aortic orifice diameter. BSD 14 mm in this case is found to be between 1/3 and 2/3 of the aortic orifice diameter, 22 mm. So moderate BSD. Maria S. C. Brenidio Kell in 2008 mentioned a case with TOP diagnosed in around 75 years of age when he came for checkup complaining of dyspnea and cyanotic spills. There was 50% overriding of the aorta and ventricular septum, 22 mm size of BSD and right ventricular infundibular obstruction, pulmonary stenosis. Here the aorta is overriding 20% of the intraventricular septum and the patient is now complaining of cyanotic spill with dyspnea as he was apparently normal before. Kras S. Kunuzul E. Spanel Borowski K. in 2003 mentioned it in TOP due to overriding of aorta. When there is pulmonary stenosis, the aortic arch is right-sided. In our case, the arch is left-sided and is overriding only 20% of the intraventricular septum. Now coming to the conclusion, Doppler echocardiography may be diagnostic tool for a case of sudden onset cyanotic spill with dyspnea, with the help of which cardiac surgeons can plan for palliative surgical procedure till a permanent remedy. So there are about 15 references till now I have collected for this case report. Thank you.